Dudes behind the foods, listeners, have you heard of Fabric Life Insurance? If you haven't, guess what? You need to get it right there, because guess what? Again, it is important for protecting your family's future with life insurance, and you're going to do that with Fabric Life Insurance. Fabric was designed by parents for parents to help you get a high quality, surprisingly affordable term for life insurance policies in less than 10 minutes. You could be offered coverage instantly with no health exam required. Protect your family today with Fabric by Gerber Life. Apply today in just 10 minutes at meetfabric.com/dudes. That's meetfabric.com/dudes, M-E-E-T. fabric.com/dudes. Policies issued by Western Southern Life Insurance Company. Not available in certain states. Prices subject to underwriting and health questions.
Dudes behind the foods. Yo, it's the dudes behind the foods. Dudes behind the foods.
Let's get it, David. So we're back in the studio. Oh my guy, dudes behind the motherfucking foods. How are you?
Very good. I believe we said this is airing after New Year's.
No. This one's gonna come out the day after Christmas.
Okay, I don't know shit. Merry Christmas after. What do you call it after the day after Christmas?
Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
God, why is that so funny? It's so stupid. Happy Christmas. It's December 26th.
Christmas Eve, Christmas, and Christmas.
This is the day where everyone like returns all their presents. And, you know what I'm saying? Gets store credit.
Let me ask you this. Mm-hmm. Somebody gives you a gift.
Yes.
You don't like it. Do you accept it, or you tell them, can I exchange it for something else?
I always accept it.
Oh, that's a good man.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's part of it. Part of the holidays is pretending to be happy with your family.
Oh, very good.
I think it's just
I love you, Chia.
Well, before we get started, I have something I want you to try, David. So,
all right.
So we like cold brew in the morning, but have you ever had a cold brew lemonade?
Why would anybody have a cold brew lemonade?
I said the same thing until I started seeing it on coffee menus
really?
In little coffee places.
Oh, you know what? I'll say this. Mm-hmm. One of my favorite drinks is actually tonics, an espresso tonic.
Oh, word.
So it might be similar to that.
So I was at a place in downtown LA and I saw cold brew lemonade on the menu and I thought, that sounds interesting. And I ordered it and I'm like, oh shit, this is my new shit.
People are doing that with orange juice. You see that shit?
Yeah, I've seen that. Have you had that?
I was like, I don't get it.
This is better.
Okay.
So check this out. But Beto, not only to do that, I kicked it up a notch, dog. I got some hard lemonade.
Is it Mike's hard lemonade?
It's not Mike. It's just the Simply.
You ever had Simply lemonade? Simply is just the good shit. You know what I'm saying? It's like fresh. And this is, I didn't even know they did a spiked version of their juices, which is why I was very excited when I saw this.
So, I'd love to have an alcohol brand.
This is watermelon lemonade. I'll see if they just have a regular lemonade. Here, okay, do this. Do like a 50-50. Mix it up a bit.
Get a cup.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. This is simply like the juice brand?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Isn't that fun?
We're finding out new things every day.
All right, so here's a little cup for you, sir.
Oh. Arigato.
How do you say you're welcome in Japanese?
Huh? You're welcome is... Shit, I don't know.
Damn.
I think you just say arigato.
They don't say thank you? I mean, they don't say you're welcome?
You know what? I don't fucking know. Let me ask my lady.
Because I just learned how to say, how do you say thank you in Italian? It's, grazie, right?
Duh.
Right. Yeah. But do you know how to say you're welcome?
Huh? Grazie.
No, it's fucking prego.
Like the sauce?
Like the sauce.
Dude, we're learning new things every day. You know, for the amount of times I imitated the language, I sure don't know anything about it.
I had to Google it one day because, you know, me and Chia kept saying grazie to each other because, you know, we like Italian food. And then one day I was like, what the fuck is you welcome? And I was like, oh, the sauce.
Prego.
Prego.
Abbondanza.
All right, there you go. So I'm doing like a half and half situation. Cold brew lemonade, but this is spiked. You know, I'm sorry your first experience is going to be with a spiked lemonade, but...
But we're trying to get crazy today, dude.
We're always trying to get crazy.
It just tastes like the Simply Spiked. It took over all the coffee flavor.
Yeah.
But yeah. I'm not mad at this. It's going to wake me up and put me to sleep.
Oh, my God. My eyes immediately, I feel it go through my body.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm going to put a little more cold brew in there. But, yeah, bro, I'm telling you, dog, cold brew lemonade, kind of the move. I like it.
It's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
So, Christmas.
Christmas, yes.
How do you celebrate Christmas is
Let
the question.
Let me tell you, David. So, Christmas, here's what I used to do. I'm going to walk you through my life, all right? Up until high school. Yeah, this is your life. Up until high school.
Draw My Life, remember that?
Oh, yeah, I did a good one, too. Did you do one?
No, it was too much work.
Mine came out sick.
Because you could draw, you idiot.
Yeah. So, when I was a little kid, I used to go to my white auntie's house. So, my dad's brother married a white woman named Jean. She was the shit. I love my Aunt Jean, okay? And so they would do all the traditional Christmas things. Like
cookies.
Yeah, cookies out for Santa, stockings by the fire.
Ooh.
Big ass Christmas tree, all that shit. Like my parents would celebrate Christmas, but not like that. You know what I'm saying? So they would take me to my auntie's house. I would stay the night with my three cousins who were all like at least 10 years older than me. I was like the little cousin that was always coming over. And then, you know, I would do the whole wake up in the morning. Santa brought presents! Wow!
Like that. You believed in Santa Claus?
Hell yeah. What do you mean believed?
Damn, Santa's not real, bro. Yeah.
This guy. You are full of it. Anyways, so I got my presents from Santa. And I'd be super excited. And so also super excited because he would eat the cookies, of course. You know, bomb-ass cookies. And then I... and then my aunt always had some fire-ass honey-baked ham. Like, that was my shit. Honey-baked ham during Christmas. I loved it. And then and we would have just a big dinner and my parents would come. I would stay the night and my parents would come over Christmas Day and we'd all celebrate with like the white side and the Asian side. And we'd all have like a big thing, open presents, all that shit. And then as I got older and all her kids got older, got families of their own, moved out, she stopped doing a big Christmas thing at her house. So then, you know, I started doing Christmas at my parents, of course. So they ended up would host all their old Thai homies and my mom would cook a big dinner. And then Christmas Eve, I would go to my Mexican homie's house. I go to Petey Flo's house because, you know, Mexicans and Filipinos celebrate Christmas Eve, or like Latinos and Filipinos celebrate Christmas Eve. And I'd go to Peter's house and, you know, have like pozole and kick it with his family. And then Christmas Day, the Mexican homies, Peter and Eric would come to my house and just have dinner and we'd kick it and just chill and stuff.
So, see, I feel like a lot of people had, like, the multiple Christmases because I don't have a lot of family here. So, we would have, like, really close family friends who also don't have a lot of family, and we would just combine our shit together. So, like, we would – every Christmas, it would be Christmas and Thanksgiving. But they would have – so, the Christmas I would spend would be with my mom's, like, best friends, and then we kind of just became family. But they had – so him, I called him my uncle. He's not really my uncle, but he's basically my uncle. So,
yeah, that's how it is.
Yeah, he's my uncle, right? So he actually has a half brother who's half, he's half black, half Korean, right? Because his mom remarried after his dad passed away.
Okay.
He married a white lady and every Christmas she would bring like the white people shit, which was like chocolate fudge, cookies or whatever. And that was like the most Christmassy thing we would have because we would always only cook Korean food. There would be no American food in our shit.
I see.
Except for my aunt, who, by the way, listen, she can cook now. She's not going to listen to this anyways. Let me tell you something. That woman's food sucked. Holy shit,
yeah,
her food fucking sucked.
I think you've told me about this woman.
Oh,
yeah.
My God, dude. Her stupid macaroni salad that she would make every year. She goes, you want me to make macaroni salad? I'm like, no, nobody wants that shit.
Would it have like ham in it and stuff? Or what kind of macaroni salad?
It was macaroni salad with like mayo. There would be hard-boiled eggs, onions, and just no salt. Or seasoning whatsoever.
Ah, I see. Yeah.
And I just never understood why she couldn't get that shit done. Like, I don't know why you're just so scared of salt. And I found out later on it was because
she had very high cholesterol.
Her husband, my uncle, was having like health shit.
Oh.
So after a while, she adjusted shit to not have any seasoning.
Oh.
So she got used to that palate. So we just never had seasoned food.
God.
Every time I would come by, she goes, make sure you stop by for some food. I'm like, fuck, I would eat this shit, dude.
You would come with like packs of soy sauce in your pocket.
She would turn away.
Squeak. Yeah.
Good God. Oh my God.
There was this meme that was super funny. It was like, when I go eat dinner at my white homie's house and the guy was bringing like seasoning in his pocket. And then a guy replied with a white guy meme. And he's like, when I go eat dinner at my black homie's house, and he had like heartburn medication in his pocket.
I had, there was also like one of my Mexican homies, like they always celebrated like Christmas and Christmas Eve to the fucking max. Mm. And every time for Christmas, I would just go to their house in the morning just because I wanted to feel Christmas vibes. Mm. I'm talking about like every fucking corner of their house was decorated with like the nutcracker shit.
Yeah.
She collected things over time, and every year we would get her an ornament to put on the tree. Aww. And the tree was like 100 feet tall every time.
Oh, fucking ridiculous. All out shit.
Crazy. It was like from the bottom all the way to the ceiling.
Isn't that great?
Dude, it's amazing. And they would have like train tracks on the top.
What?
Dog, everything.
Like a fucking Home Alone movie.
Yes, dude. Like the wow. shit you would see on TV. That's how much they decorate their shit.
That's amazing.
I took Mariel.
Yeah.
This is years ago when we first started dating. She visited Sacramento. I took them to their house and she was like, what the fuck is this?
Wow.
This is Christmas.
So you didn't believe in Santa, huh?
No.
Wow. You're part of the reason why he doesn't come around anymore.
Yeah, I threatened him, but he came through. I didn't believe. He's like, I am. Get the fuck out of my house, bro.
Dog, even
fuck you talking about?
The 1 year where I had been talking to kids at school, like, you know, there's always that one fucking asshole kid that was like, you know, Santa's not real, right? And then so I was at my white auntie's house, and I'm like, and also this was when her mom was still alive. So that was like, I also called her grandma. That was my white grandma. And I was like, did you guys buy these presents? Because it was a pile of presents from Santa. And the white grandma, she's like, what? How could you? Oh my. Okay, I'll admit, I bought this one, but the rest are from Santa. And I was like, okay.
Wow.
I was like, oh God, okay, what a relief.
Well, okay, so this is the thing I'm always curious about, right? Yeah. Because I never believed in Santa Claus because my parents never brought up Santa Claus to me. Mm-hmm, the mm-hmm. only Santa Claus was Jesus Christ himself, my Lord and my Savior.
Oh, well,
for he gives me everything I need, and the things I do not need in my life, he takes it out.
Wait, you still believe in him though?
Wait, Jesus isn't real? Hold on. This fucking guy here, man. He's crazy. Oh, dude, you nuts, man.
You know,
you almost got me.
You still put out the communion crackers for Jesus to come and eat on Christmas?
It's a Christmas miracle.
Santa Claus is Christmas, and Jesus' real holiday is Christmas. And he's like, what the hell, guys? Where's my shit? No one believes in Christmas anymore.
He starts disappearing. You don't believe? It's a Christmas miracle.
That's so dumb.
That's so funny to me.
Oh, my God.
Dog. I'm gonna make a shirt next year just says Merry Christmas, and nobody's gonna know what the fuck. Like,
what is this?
Like, you don't know. You don't bring out your communion crackers.
You don't celebrate Christmas? It's Christmas, dude.
Make sure you put out the blood of Jesus Christ and those little crackers every Christmas.
Oh, bro.
Oh, I'm going to say that to people, and everybody, nobody's going to know what we're talking about.
Dog, people got so mad at me because I made a communion joke on Instagram, and like Christian... super Christian followers were like on my ass. They were so offended, and I said nothing offensive. All right, I did this fucking thing with Nikki Blades where we took a shot of like tequila and we went ooh and we felt it. And I said, when you take a shot of when you take a shot of Jesus' blood at communion and you feel the Holy Spirit, right? And here's why it's not offensive. First of
Wait,
all,
how is that offensive in the first place?
Exactly. So people were like, man, you gotta stop. You gotta stop playing with Jesus' name, man. Like, that's not a joke. I'm like, wait, what are you talking about, guys? Like, literally, when you take communion, they tell you this is the blood and body of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
The wine represents the blood, and the crackers represent the body. So like, I'm saying, when you drink the communion drink and then you feel the Holy Spirit, like, what is offensive?
That is literally what is supposed to happen.
It's literally what they tell you that the wine is supposed to represent, the blood and body of Jesus Christ. So I'm like, when you take a sip of Jesus' blood and you feel the Holy Spirit, like, what the fuck is the issue?
Yeah.
But they were so mad. And here's the thing, if I would have just phrased it like, when you sip your communion juice and you feel the Holy Spirit, It's the exact same thing.
This is the weird thing about that. This is what I very much dislike. It's like people who say, number one, you have absolutely no right to say that when you say you're playing with God's name, because you're watching his content. So like the idea behind that is so weird because they're going to like religious and moral selectivism, right? Mm. So it's like, oh, I get to cast stones at Tim because I feel that he's playing with God's name. I'm pretty sure you said the word, oh my God. That's literally playing with God's name.
You're saying the name of the Lord in vain?
Yeah. you're watching like pussy and dick jokes.
Yeah.
Which is vulgar.
Yeah.
Which is not the way your mouth is supposed to be used. It's supposed to be used to praise God only. Are you fucking out of your mind? Don't talk to me about your religious moral selectives. I will fuck you up.
Some
man.
People will say that the Bible says if you even look at a woman in a sensual manner, like you want her body, that is adultery. So you hear my fucking jokes, hear us joke about big old jiggly butts and you laugh at that?
And you're going, this king right here. He knows what he's to this king right here.
But you want to get mad at me for saying exactly what we do during communion? What the fuck?
Yeah. And how is he a king? Idolatry, huh?
Huh.
Yeah, let's cast some fucking
That's
stones.
That's right. Oh, you looking at me as a king? You idolizing me?
Yeah. And how many times have you seen me naked?
Oh, I'm committing adultery right now.
How many times have you seen these chichis?
I'm committing gay adultery, double sin according to the Bible. Wow.
Well, you've double sinned? Double Chris Mice.
Cancel Chris Mice.
You are not getting your Chris Mice gifts.
You're getting lumps of J. Cole's album in your stocking. That's the Chris Mice rules. And we're gonna drink some Jesus blood and be right back after this message. Oh man, look, if you need a New Year's resolution idea, then I have a suggestion, okay? Stop putting it off and finally get life insurance. It is important. Fabric by Gerber Life is the easy, all online solution that you've been waiting for. I'm a family man now, and not only do I need insurance for myself, but hello, I got a wife, a baby, another baby on the way. Life insurance is important. I want to make sure they're taken care of if I just happen to get hit by a bus. You know what I'm saying? Fabric was designed by parents for parents to help you get a high quality, surprisingly affordable term life insurance policy in less than 10 minutes. All right. It takes less than 10 minutes to apply, see your quote, and then personalize your quote to fit your family's needs. You could be offered coverage instantly with no health exam required. And let me tell you this, Fabric was specifically designed to give parents like you affordable term life insurance, plus wills, access to college savings funds, and more tools to help protect your family's financial future, all in an easy online experience, all right? So join me. Protect your family today with Fabric by Gerber Life. Apply today in just 10 minutes at meetfabric.com/dudes. That's meetfabric.com/dudes, M-E-E-T, fabric.com/dudes. Policies issued by Western Southern Life Assurance Company. Not available in certain states. Prices subject to underwriting and health questions. Yeah, man, but people were mad. I was like, and this was the first time someone was like, you should probably delete this, bro. I'm like, for
nope.
What?
Nope.
I like, and normally if people are kind of feeling touchy about something, I'll be like, all right, fine, I'll get rid of it if someone feels offended. But this time I was like, no, guys, I went to Christian school for fucking like 12 years of my life. I know what I'm talking about here. There is nothing offensive. And I was literally arguing with everybody. This is the first time I was like, no, I'm arguing with everybody because y'all sound dumb, yeah. You know? And it really irritates me when people, they're like blinded by what they like feel and they're not actually looking at what it's going on. You feel me?
Oh no, that's 100%. Like I just did this video, you know, talking about like, sometimes I feel like Asian people get gaslit on like our racial issues, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then I kind of literally in a 10-minute video, I explained why I feel this way. And somebody goes, I don't understand why you feel this way. Basically what the comment was saying, I was like, just watch the video.
Right.
And he goes, I don't understand why you're talking to your fans. I was like, no, that's not me being rude. I'm saying if you watch the video, the first question is, he basically writes like, why do you feel like you're so offended by what this one person said? In the beginning of the video, I say, the reason why I'm doing this video is this. Mm. And I'm like, So you didn't watch the video because I literally said the reason why I'm doing this video is this. Mm-hmm. I'm not offended at the person. I'm offended at how people are reacting in the comments. Mm-hmm. And he goes, I don't understand why you made the video. I was like, you didn't watch the video then.
Bro, people literally, okay, look, check this out. Here's what's crazy, right? So I did a skit a long time ago, which I recently repurposed into a reel mm-hmm. where I give a homeless gentleman, $1,000. But
by the way, homeless people don't care that you call them unhoused.
Yeah, I mean, that's facts.
Legit, they don't give a fuck.
Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, they're not on Twitter.
Yeah, they're not sitting here like, excuse me, I am unhoused. No, they have bigger things to worry about. Yes. They don't give a fuck.
Yeah, exactly.
And this is from somebody who volunteers at homeless shelters. Don't fucking, I've never heard one of them go, hey, bro. Chill with the fucking homeless shit, man. All right? I'm unhoused. Fuck out of here, dude.
Yeah, exactly,
you
right?
You non-volunteering bitches. You don't know shit.
So here's the thing, too. I even, like, so for the caption for this, when I repurposed the video, I didn't even call him a homeless dude. I was like, there's a guy sleeping in a box, and I gave him $1,000, but I said he had to use it to, he had to pay it forward. He had to help somebody mm-hmm. else, right? So basically, in the video, you know, I give him $1,000, but I come back later and he spent all the money on like alcohol and strippers, right? That's the bit. And the whole point of this video was to make fun of those super corny, like, yo, like, let's see what happens if I give this hungry man like a pizza. Let's see what, you know, and I'm like, and I feel like those videos are kind of what's the word? Exploiting homeless people.
Oh, 100%.
You feel me? And so my whole point of my video was to satire that, right? But then you have people who are like, one who are like so offended by this video because like there are people that really live like this. I'm like, I didn't say he was homeless in the real.
Yeah.
Like, he's just a guy sleeping in a box. But also there was one guy who was like, why would you film it if you're gonna help this dude? I'm like, bro, did you click out after a second and a half? Like, literally a reel is like 30 seconds long. I'm like, how long did you like click on this before you left your comment?
Look at this guy here, virtue signaling. It's like, this is the sketch where I'm making fun of those people. How do you not know this isn't a sketch?
Yeah, like, how long? Like, literally, dog. Like, the joke takes place after, like, 10 seconds. Like, what the fuck?
Sometimes I'm always like, oh, maybe it's just a troll. But I was like, nope, this is a real person. And they're actually offended.
Oh, bro, let me tell you. Speaking of trolls, there was somebody who was in my TikTok comments the other day. And I was like, is this guy, this guy's really mad at me for some reason, right? And then, until I saw another, and I was going to comment back until I realized, oh, this man is really just finding a reason to be mad at me for some reason. Like, at first he was saying a bunch of bullshit about, like, I don't know, I forget, like some shit about like disgrace to Asians, like random shit.
I was I get that all the time.
Yeah, dude. I was like, what are you saying, sir?
Hello.
And then he left a comment on, you know, when I do those videos where I'm in Costco waiting for samples and I put the sad
hilarious
music.
Hilarious.
Oh, well, thank you. And those do the best for me on, like, you know, short for TikTok reels, all that shit. Anyways, this guy left a comment and he was like, he was like, you can tell he's not really popping, or else he would have done this in a Vons or a Ralph's.
Wait, what does that mean?
I have no idea. He's like
reaching. He's like,
it was. I've never seen a reach like this. He was like, oh, you can tell he's not really successful, or else this video would have been done at Ralph's. I was like, what?
What does that mean?
I don't know.
How is, like, that even applicable at a Ralph's?
None of it makes, exactly. Ralph's doesn't give samples. Like, none of it makes sense. And that's what I replied. I was like, okay, I see who you are. I see what is going on in your life. Yeah. I was like, carry on with whatever comments you want to leave, because you're not making sense, bro. Yeah. You know, I was just like, all right, I'm out, man. Cool. You know?
No, there's, I kind of, like, years ago, I've mentioned this before about my podcast, where, like, I found out about this Reddit where they just fucking hate me. And I just was like, damn, man. People can really spend a lot of energy just, like, you literally live inside their whole world.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's kind of odd.
Yeah.
You know, and, like, I'm not saying this in the sense of me telling you that, oh, I feel bad for them. I'm not saying that. I just genuinely feel very weird towards people who kind of wake up. The first thing they do is check a thread to be like, hey, what else can we hate on this person?
Yeah.
And it's like, damn, man, like, life is so much more entertaining. Like, you could feel a certain way too. And like I said too, I had a few people, I know a few people at Reddit. They're like, oh, we could find something to take this thread down. I was like, God, there's no point, because I don't like doing that, right? Mm. You could feel the way that you feel because I said something that pissed you off that you didn't vibe with. So I feel like I would be a hypocrite if I try to get that taken down.
Yeah.
So I just let it live. I just try to wrap my head around like the idea of waking up every day to be like, all right, this is what I'm going
to
do.
It has to be exhausting.
You would be successful if you was getting samples at a box. Yeah, and he walks away, smokes a cigarette. He's like,
got that, fool.
That's a Chris Spice miracle.
I'm going to sing some Chris Spice carols about that shit right there, homie.
I'm just saying that on Christmas. Yo, bro, I don't celebrate Christmas, bro. I only celebrate Christmas.
It's so dumb. But yeah, man, like, it just hate for no reason, right? And I'm like, it. And, you know, we've said this before, but, you know, I like to talk back to negative comments and haters sometimes, because especially when I'm taking a shit, I sit there for like 20, 30 minutes and I'm like, let me just, all right, I got time, right? But I also have to check myself sometimes, like, all right, bro, like, why are you wasting energy on this shit?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Like, especially when there's a Taoist principle that I try to live my life according to. It helps me save a lot of time. And it's he who angers you controls you, right?
Mm.
And
fire.
Yeah, and it's so simple, but it resonates hard, right? Because it's like, ah, fuck. It's like, yes, why am I, when life is so short, right? Why am I letting this person affect my day for even like 5 minutes? You know what I'm saying? Like, Why am I wasting my energy to comment on this person that like means nothing to me, right? So I have to remind myself sometimes of that, but also sometimes I'm like, man, fuck this motherfucker, bro. Like, you ain't shit, and I fucked your mom.
Sometimes two people don't understand where they go, why do you put your time into this? Because most of the time it's just, I think for people who are just like goofy people,
We're
always just looking to roast or like make jokes.
Yes, yes, yes.
So it's not like it eats up the day. It's right. More like in the moment, it's like, oh, this might be hella funny.
Yes. Bah, 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 yes.
And then we kind of move on with our lives. It's not like we don't really talk about it unless it's for a podcast.
And that's the thing too, on the same token, right? On the flip side of that shit, it's like, it's not really a waste of time because, like I said, I'm taking a shit. I can take 2 seconds to reply to your comment. And also the beauty of comments nowadays, right, with YouTube, Instagram, when you reply to that one negative comment, everyone sees it. So they fucking roast this fool. On YouTube, you reply to a comment, everybody is like laughing, right? And it's fun to take the screenshot and be like, look what this little stupid ass boy said and look what I said back, you know?
You responded recently to an Instagram thing and it got fucking taken down.
Oh.
Dude. Welcome to my fucking world, dude. That's my whole world. I had a similar situation, right, where somebody wrote some obscene shit towards me.
Yeah.
Right? And I wrote back, shut the fuck up before I kiss you on your fucking mouth. Right? And then my comment got taken down because I threatened to love him. I was like, but that's all I said. I was like, shut your fucking mouth before I kiss you. And then I got sent for, this is inappropriate. I was like, this fool told me to go kill myself.
Ugh. Now, mind you, mine was a little petty, uneven, because he was just like, what did he say? Oh, he said, you suck.
It's such a basic.
And I said, I suck your mom's ashy clit. And
inappropriate, bro. And
bullying, inappropriate. But I took a screenshot, I reposted the screenshot of that getting reported. And even though his comment was just so just nothing, I was like, this will be funny, right? And I just really, when I thought of ashy clit in my head, I just thought it was like so funny. So I was like, I have to leave this comment.
Yeah.
And all the comments were like, damn, Tim, ashy though? Ashy? I'm like, yeah, dude.
In your face, dusty vagina.
Yeah, because it gives you a visual too, you know?
It's gross.
Yeah.
It looks like a dried up abalone, you piece of shit.
Ew. Looks like just a little overcooked scallop.
I'd still eat it though.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, but it's weird, like, when you have to, I do understand though, when sometimes, like, I think we get kind of caught up in like the negative comments too much, it kind of takes away from your day.
I know.
I do get that. I think when I first started YouTube, the first 2 years were like that, where I think I didn't understand what the internet was exactly yet, you know? And then you start to realize, oh, people are just talking their shit. Let them talk their shit. And then I remember I got this comment years ago. It's like, I find it really fucked up that the only time you respond is when you respond to negative comments. But when we say nice things, you don't say anything at all.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh shit, that is fucking true, man. Like, I never give praise to people who are trying to connect on like a positive note.
Right.
And then every time somebody says something bad, I have to respond. But that's what they like. They go, well, the only way he's going to respond back to me if I say something negative.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, okay, maybe I'm the one that's kind of feeding this like negative machine.
Well, you know what I try to do now? For every hater comment I reply to, I try to reply to two positive comments to even it out. Because I do realize that that happens. You know, it's so easy to see 100 positive comments, laugh emojis, and you see one guy who says, you suck. And you're like, this motherfucker, are you kidding me?
Ashy clip.
Bro, but people reach so hard sometimes. I remember one time this girl tried to, she was really trying to burn me about anything she could think of, right? And she came after, she said, my hairline is receding.
Oh, your hairline's fine.
My hairline is beautiful.
It's actually the thing I hate about you the most.
My hairline has been literally like the same in the past, like, I don't know how many years.
And if you've seen his parents, this fool's hair is going to grow even in the grave. And it's going to come out as a tree.
My hair will just get like white when I get old. The hairline's not going anywhere. And then they also tried to say, they were like, and he's losing elasticity in his face. And I was like,
damn,
what?
That is the craziest insult I've ever heard in my life, dude.
I was like, and bro, this was like 10 years ago. You know, I might be getting a little gobble now, but back then my shit was pretty popping. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, what are you talking about, woman?
See, this is why you're so like positive. It's hard for people to insult you, so they have to reach for the deepest things ever, dude. And look at his earlobes. They're growing.
They're connected to his face. Ew.
People just try so fucking hard, man. But I understand, man. The internet is so weird. Like, even when I look at Twitter,
yeah,
I feel like the hottest thing people are doing now, like, people are such clout chasers to the point where they'll try to roast Elon, even if they don't necessarily think too much about him.
Yeah.
But they want to get the retweets so bad.
Oh, from him?
Yeah.
They're
just trying to roast Elon so bad, and people just to cheer that. It's like, I bet you don't even actually care. This is very weird. Like, Twitter used to be kind of funny.
It was really funny. I mean, you know, when we came up on Twitter, like in our early generation of Twitter, Twitter was just like, let's just say the most like reckless thing that comes to mind, right? Mm-hmm. It's different now, you know what I'm saying? And I do like what Twitter had evolved into. It's very, you know, you can get news immediately. You can hear all types of opinions. But then it became of like, God, you have to hear all types of opinions of like stupid ones, you know? And here's what's annoying on Twitter is like, you have someone say one stupid, ignorant, annoying thing, and then you have like three people agreeing with them, and they're like, oh, yes, I am so right about this. Yeah. My opinion is completely valid. And, you know, and that's the thing about Twitter. I've said this before. People don't go on Twitter to have conversations.
Mm-hmm.
They go in there to say their dumbass take. Wait for other people to agree, and that's the only reason that they're there. They either want to be gassed up with agreements or they want to argue. No one comes to Twitter to be like, hey, I want to have a like open communication. Like, that's not what people do on Twitter, and that's where it became annoying, you know? Yeah. Like, no one gives a fuck.
We've seen this too, where, you know, some people blame the stupidity of the world on the internet, right? Mm-hmm. I think the internet was supposed to make people smarter because you have so much knowledge at your fingertips.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right? Even if not everything's true, but you do have enough to kind of research your own shit and then kind of form your own opinion.
Mm-hmm.
But then what happened was, is like, I always said this, the internet didn't make people stupid. It gave stupid people a voice.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know?
Totally.
And you find out that there's more dumb people in this world than there are smart people.
Mm-hmm.
And more people who are hyper emotional rather than people who like think shit through.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what happens. Like, they'll put like a dumb opinion out. They'll get like 20,000, you know, retweets, and they go, yeah, I'm fucking right.
Because it's a bunch, 20,000 stupid ass people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of the things that I always warn young people about is like, if you ever engage in a conversation with somebody who does this is like the hottest thing that young people do when they argue. You'll say something like this. I don't like lemonade, right? Oh, you fucking hate lemon farmers who are working to feed their family? You know, you're saying that they're not fucking important,
right?
Because those people have jobs, so you don't care about humanity.
Right.
They'll take an argument that you can agree with, which is like human, like a man taking care of himself to prove their argument. That's not even a part of the conversation. Mm. And that's what all you motherfuckers do. And you are literally the dumbest person in the room.
Bro, I got into a huge back and forth with some guy in Tony Baker's comments, okay? Because Tony Baker, remember when everybody was doing the AI shit, right?
Yeah,
they were using the Lensa app and they're making all these fucking like really cool AI generated pictures of themselves, right? And then they became a thing where it's like, oh wait, this app, they said could be stealing from like real artists, right? Mm-hmm. From generating like all these, from getting information from all these images on the internet, right? But so when it became super pop and trend that week, and a lot of people were doing it, then you had the people who were like, ugh, you will never see me use this app, blah, 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 right? Tony made a post and he's like, hey, you're not cool just because you don't wanna do something that's trendy. He's like, let people have their fun. If people wanna do like, AI posts themselves like, you're not cool just because you think you're better than the trend, right? Saying that like people aren't cool because they don't want to do the trend, right? So then he had all these comments where people were like, nah, Tony, don't support this app. It steals from artists. AI is a very dangerous thing for artists. And like it's stealing work from like real people that make computer art. And I'm like, and Tony, he's like, I'm not talking about that, guys. I'm talking about people that think they're too cool for apps, right? Or for trends. And I left a similar comment. I was like, LOL, all these people getting deep about creativity and artistry and theft. I'm like, he's just talking about trends, right?
Yeah.
So this guy was commenting with me back and forth, arguing with me. He's like, yeah, but I'm sure when an AI comes out that does like comedy bits and comedy sketches, you'll change your tune. I'm like, that's not what we're talking about.
It's a separate conversation. Yeah.
So then he starts going back and forth. Nah, but this is taking money from artists and this blah, blah, blah. I'm like, I agree with you. That's not what Tony's saying here. And then I'm like, back and forth. And I'm like, look, man, obviously you're not trying to listen. You're not hearing me. So cool. Have a nice day. And then he's like, yeah, people always end the conversation when they don't have anything left to say. I'm like, you know what? Fine then. Let's get into it, you motherfucker. So then I'm going back. I wrote a fucking paragraph. I'm like, here's what you fucking did, dog. If Tony said, hey, people that drive Teslas have funny looking faces. And you were like, you know what? The gas industry is becoming a really big problem. That's why we need electric cars. And he's like, that is not a relevant metaphor.
That is exactly what you're doing.
Yeah, I'm like, you're not listening to me. Yeah. So finally, I was like, look, bro, if you don't understand my metaphor, what I'm trying to say, just I gotta get out of this, bro, because you're not fucking hearing me. I literally agree with everything you're saying about AI and the issues with it and stealing from artists. That's not what we're talking about. Finally, he fucking DMs me, and he's like, hey, man, just no hard feelings. I'm like, bruh, you're so frustrating. This is all in DMs. I'm like, you're fucking frustrating. I agree with you. That's not what this is about. He was like, honestly, man, I was like 12 beers deep. He's like, I'm sorry. I didn't hear what you were saying. I'm like, thank you, God.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like that level of, it's, you know, straw man shit. Like you guys, and the sad thing is like, even if he wasn't like 12 beers deep, that is how he communicates. Mm-hmm. And people communicate like that with anybody who has an argument. They try to get that emotional tag. They go, okay, these fucking paper cups are whack. People feed people, you know, sorry we can't afford fine glasses like you because, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
So they're trying to win the argument through another emotional tie that has nothing to do with this. And that is how like 90% of arguments are online. Yeah. And it's just a weird thing that people can't see through. Like if you're a young person, the moment you had that conversation, stop talking and walk away. Mm-hmm. Because you're not going to be able to convince them otherwise.
They're not trying to listen.
They're not trying to listen. This is not a conversation.
I used to use that to troll people that would talk shit on videos. Like if someone was like, wow, Tim, you only use clickbait. I'm sick of using clickbait. I'm like, I'm using this clickbait to get views on my videos so I can feed my family? You don't want me to take care of my parents, you asshole? Yeah. You don't care about my mom who's like struggling, or my wife who we just had a child? You don't want me, you're taking food out of my baby's mouth? Are you kidding me?
But that's like I'm saying. But that's so funny when you do it as a joke, you know? Mm. But that's how people legit argue.
Yeah, man.
And I started realizing that early on. I'm like, oh, this is what adults would talk to me about when I was younger, you know? And I'm not sure if I did it when I was younger, but I don't think like I ever got into deep conversations like that when I was, because we didn't have Twitter and shit like that.
Yeah.
We used to be fucking around. We're trying to like hit on girls or do whatever.
Yeah.
So I don't think I would ever engage in conversations. I don't know. Maybe the generation is just fucking different because now it's like, how can I get on this woke shit?
I know.
So people can fucking love me.
And look, to be fair, you know, it's great that people are having conversations that they would normally have, right? But, bruh, like, I just remember, you know, when we were, like you said, when we were younger, we did so much just fucking around, you know what I'm saying? And it was like, I remember, bro, I was filming this show and a part of it was we went to this classroom where the program was helping kids that wouldn't have access to, like, video editing and shit like that, just like learn how to, you know, produce videos and edit. It was a great program, right? And then the instructor, she asked, you know, what would you want to like make content about, right? Really simple question. And literally every kid was about like, you know what? It just seems like the socioeconomical state of the world just needs people need to understand. I'm like, when did y'all, can y'all just have fun?
Yeah.
Like, be kids, please.
Because they're trying to say the right answer versus saying how they feel.
Right.
Right? And that's the hard part, too. It's like, you're being dishonest.
Or maybe that's how they feel, David.
No, that's not how they feel.
Maybe that's how they feel.
They feel like they want to say the right thing all the time. And that's impossible. It's okay for you not to say the right thing. Sometimes, if you just want to say, what content do you want to make? I just want to make stupid shit. That's more honest.
Yeah. Well, we're going to talk about stupid shit literally right after this fucking break. Want some caviar and crackers?
I would like some charcuterie on Christmas. Sometimes, kids, you know, one of the my favorite thing that I like to say is three words put together. I don't know. You could just not know things sometimes, man.
100%.
And it's cool, you know what I mean? Like, you ain't got to know everything.
I think there is power in being able to not fucking fake that shit and be like, honestly, I have no idea what this means.
Yep, and it creates a better conversation, man. Yes. That's what happens like in Hollywood shit. They'll always be dropping names, and I don't know who the fuck these people are. They're like, and it's the way they say it to you sometimes. It's like, dude, I am not gonna know this obscure Nicaraguan director.
Oh, dude, let me tell you something, dog. I love when someone is like, yeah, so, you know, I was with, you know, Nick Schwartz, right? And I'm like, and I love going, who? Or like, have you seen the show Coffee and Lemonade? I'm like, no. And I will always say no. Or when people are like, I fucking can't stand, bro. When people will assume that you know about some abstract indie band or some shit, they're like, okay, so.
How would I know this?
So I was at Caviar and Crackers show the other night and I'm like, who? And I'm like, you never heard of Caviar? No!
That's why he just said who.
I don't know this fucking random band you follow, dog.
Yeah.
I hate it.
It's like, dude, in the indie scene, they're like popping right now. It's like, yeah, well, indie scene, how would I know? And don't make me sound stupid for not fucking knowing this thing.
Yeah, dude, I'm not from India.
I don't know this fucking, and he's like, oh, this guy's actually dumb. I had no clue how dumb he was. That's what I'm saying. I don't know, guys. Just try saying that. And sometimes, too, I know it's hard because you want to be in the know. You don't want to feel like you're the person that's always left out. But guess what? If you say, I don't know, the next conversation you have after you learn that, then you'll know. But if you keep pretending, it just gets really uncomfortable.
Yeah, man.
Like those Hollywood conversations too, if you guys ever get into entertainment, you'll see that happen all the time. Like there's this guy who has been a part of this industry. He's like an agent and he wants to sound like he knows everything.
Ugh.
So he'll go, it's like, listen, dude, Sasha Bilinovic. Bilinovic just did this amazing black and white film noir piece. You know him, right? And I literally say the same thing. I was like, bro, how the fuck am I supposed to know who that is? You know? And honestly, when you make jokes like that, it opens it up way better.
Yeah.
Because I hate going, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, I know who you're talking. And I go, I don't know what the fuck. Who the fuck is that?
And sometimes I feel like I should watch more. I should consume more content. Like, you know, on that side of things, when people are like, you know, when you do these meetings with producers or whatever, and they're like, so what are you watching lately? What are you into? And I'm like, Bob's Burgers reruns?
Yeah. I always do something back where they say something and they go, oh, you don't know who that is? I'm like, dude, you know who Senchai is? You go, who's that? I said, exactly, bro. I was like, he's one of the most famous Muay Thai kickboxers in all of Thailand. In all of kickboxing. You wouldn't know who the fuck that is.
Oh, bro, random quick tangent. The other day I was just like fucking around with Chia. I'm having problems opening this. I'll get to it. But yeah,
it's taking so long.
I was with Chia and she was just on the couch and I was like, I had energy. I was running around the living room and I was like, what happened? You cut yourself?
No.
Oh, continue. Okay. And I was like, you know, and like my trainer, cause I've been with a trainer lately. Oh my God. Thank you. Oh, he has a box cutter. Thank you.
Just in case I need to cut people's faces.
So I was like, my trainer, who's been trying to get me fit and shit, we do boxing lessons for cardio, right? So I'm like, all right, babe, so check this out. So this is one and then two, right? And I'm doing this shit. She's like, babe, do not David sew me. do not start David sewing in this house, please.
You know, I always threaten to punch her. I always be like throwing punches at her face all the time.
Now, when Isabel David first really started getting to, you know when you kick it with a dancer and all they're doing is choreography in between conversations? That was David, but with like, you know, punches and shit, you know? And she's like, please, please don't start that.
Let me tell you something, man. There's a video where people do that. Like when you first start kickboxing and you shadow box everywhere. It's so true though, because you're so obsessed with it and you just want to get your shit right. You just nonstop do that all day.
We'd be like, and like shooting Sen Foods and like outside of a bar, this fool would be drunk, like kicking like, kicking like signs and shit.
There's a video of that, of me trying to kick a water. I don't even remember that video, but I was so fucking drunk. I was like trying to do Muay Thai kicks on this like pole and shit. Oh, so funny, dude.
Well, would you like some caviar and crackers?
I would love caviar.
I knew I just wanted some type of food because I brought two kinds of alcohol for today, but I didn't bring any food. So I just grabbed something real quick at the BevMo.
Oh, BevMo is amazing.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Where?
Pass me the caviar, bro.
Oh.
What type of caviar is this?
This is
Paddlefish.
Alright. Not mad. There's also we have a truffle whitefish roe.
I like this.
I like it too.
Oh, this is good.
Yeah. I just like caviar, to be honest.
This with this buttery Ritz?
Mm-hmm.
This is really fire.
Oh, speaking of Ritz, do you know what Rizz is?
Bro, that's so fucking funny that you just say that, right? I've been seeing that word all over the place.
Yeah.
No idea.
I love it. All right, so Rick was the one that told me about what Rizz is. Like months and months ago, Rick was like, yo, the kids got this word. It's called Rizz. And basically it means like you have game or you're charming. So it's like when somebody goes up to a girl and they're like, when you see someone just very charismatic with women, like the comments are like, oh, he got that Rizz. Oh, my guy got the like.
Is it from the word charismatic?
Oh my God.
You think so? You just said
Yeah.
Hey, somebody in the comments, did I just figure something out?
You might have just, oh. That makes me like the word that much more. The fact that it comes from a real word. Thing. Because some of this shit, I feel like just comes out of nowhere. I'm like, what the fuck does this even mean? But like, I already like Rizz just because it makes me laugh, right? Like, like Like, let's say you were, like, trying to talk to a girl and you were using fucking caviar. They'd be like, oh, damn, he got that crackers Rizz. Oh, he got the Rizz crackers. Like, everything is like, oh, he got the blah, blah, blah Rizz.
He got the Rizz crackers.
And it makes me laugh, right?
I love it.
But, oh, the fact that you made it real right now? Oh, charisma.
Hey, if it's from the word charisma, hey, somebody donate some money to me right now because I'm a genius.
I don't know if we talked about it on this show, but did we talk about where no cap potentially comes from?
No, I have no idea.
Okay, so of course, as y'all know, no cap means like I'm not lying, or cap means, oh, he's lying, mm-hmm. right? So I was on Twitter one day and I'm like, look, man, great, slang words, great. Can someone please tell me why no cap means I'm not lying, or why cap means lying? Please someone tell me. And so many comments of people were just like, oh, it's from this city. It's, oh, it means like you're not lying. I'm like, I understand that. Why?
Yeah.
Though. And finally, one person was like, in Atlanta, was it Atlanta? Whatever city, they were like, oh, where it originated, or New Orleans, where it originated, if someone had fake gold fronts on, the gold caps, they were like, and not real gold in their grill, then they were like, oh, that's cap. Like, those are fake, that's fake gold. And if they had real gold fronts, it was like, oh, that's not cap. And that's, they said that's where it comes from. And I was like, oh, all right, well now.
That's pretty cool.
Well then, cool then, right?
I love shit like that when you find out how things like originate.
Mm-hmm.
It, like the great context behind it. And I want to know who the person was. Who was the person that said that, dude? You know, you started a whole fucking thing, man.
Are you familiar with the food does not smack argument? Or food does not slap?
Of course, because I'm from Sacramento. I'm from NorCal. And, you know, everybody was so particular about that, and I didn't give a fuck. You can say words however the fuck that you want, you know? So, like, obviously, when you say, oh, that shit fucking schmacks, you're only supposed to say that with food.
Right, because, no. Oh, yes.
Yeah,
yes,
and yes, slaps yes. is supposed to be for music,
right?
So, I remember early on, I heard somebody say it the other way around. I was like, oh, maybe they just do it different, whatever, that's fine. But then, dog, in the comments, people are like, that's not what you do.
Yeah.
All right? Food is schmacks.
Yeah.
And music slaps.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, I don't give a fuck what you say.
Well, I try to, you know, I understand that slang evolves and it changes, especially where you go. And pretty much a lot of places will say, oh, food slaps now, right? And I remember I got a homegirl in Seattle, this girl, Tina, who does food like TikToks, right? And she said a food slaps in one of her shits, and people were in her comments like going
hard.
And I until one day, open up this truffle one.
Oh.
It's truffle roe, white fish. And I tweeted, I was like, hey, just so you know,
I'm not friends with her.
Guys, I do not associate with this person. But I was like, no, look, hey, E40, who is the originator of the term slaps. Specifically says food does not slap. Food does not slap. So, and I sent her a little video of him saying that specifically. She was like, okay, well, if E40 says it, I take it back.
Only he can tell me when to go.
And plus, I know, like, you know, especially Seattle kind of being a West Coast city, you know, they also respect that, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I'm like, hey, check this out. This is where it comes from.
The crazy thing was, and I talked about this with my buddy, Soosh, he's a rapper out in Sacramento, now in LA, was like, when we watched the evolution of what the internet can do with music and globalize it, was specifically for me was Bay Area music.
Yeah.
Bay Area music was so particular to Bay Area, right? That Casio keyboard type of shit, super simplistic music. Anybody can make that shit on Fruity Loops.
Oh, the beats, yeah.
Yep. And then I started hearing fucking Mac Dre, Andre Nicotino out in SoCal when I was in college. I'm like, the fuck? How are you guys listening to fucking Mac Dre? And then Tell Me When to Go popped off.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody was on that shit. Mm-hmm. Everybody started ghostwriting their whips. I'm like, man, that's some shit I only saw in my high school.
Yeah.
And I started seeing people doing it in SoCal. I was like, oh, music is becoming global now.
And then after fucking Tell Me When to Go, then you started hearing all the other like Bay Area classics like fucking ding, 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 ding. Ding, 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 ding. Ivy.
Keep the sneak, baby.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And that's kind of, I love when that happens. Like, I love when you're in a club and you see all the fucking Bay Area people come out of the fucking woodworks as soon as you put on that shit, you know?
Yeah, that I mean. Sheezy, baby. I fucking love that shit. That era was, it's funny because like music purists, even at the time, they were like, this ain't real music.
Mm.
But you couldn't help but bop your fucking head to it because it was so fucking fun.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think like that's the thing that's what's happening right now with the music that we used to be so critical of. It's like, oh, that's that shit. It's like you just want to bop your head to it. That's all that it is. Don't look too deep into it.
That's why I've never really been mad at like when people want to have the, oh, this isn't real hip hop because it doesn't have a message.
Yeah, different categories.
Yeah,
because
like hip hop is such a, it's such a wide array of different types of shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you never have people, like nobody in like rock, well, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong about this, but like, you know, you don't have rock people like, nah, this isn't real rock. You know, because like, this guy's going to sing about this shit and this guy's going to sing about this shit, right? But hip hop is so like, you know, I mean, of course, because, you know, how it started.
It's the roots.
It comes from like, you know, like your storytelling and messages and stuff. But when people, but also, man, if you go way back, fucking Sugar Hill Gang, that's like, they're just having fun. Mm-hmm. To have, you know, just dance music, having a good time telling a fun story. So I never subscribe to the message of, nah, this ain't real hip hop. He ain't talking about nothing. Like, sometimes you just want to dance.
I think it's the variety now. I kind of feel half and half about this, but there's a lot more variety for people to pick and choose from, you know? I think, like, there are things that you could say definitively, like, oh, this motherfucker don't got bars.
Yeah.
But is he trying to have bars?
Right.
Or is he trying to just make fun party music?
Exactly.
Like, I'll go to bat for people who, like, they'll do, like, a freshman XL and they're freestyling, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's terrible. And then somebody writes, oh, that's bars. I'm like, no, that's not bars.
Right.
It's fun.
Yeah.
It's not bars, though.
I know.
You know what I mean? When you're rhyming the same word with the same word four times, that's not bars.
But did you hear how he rhymed it, though?
Oh, with the triplet. Oh, I see what you're saying, though. Not bad, huh?
I spilled a little caviar. Sorry about it.
Oh, that's going to smell for years in here. Well, guys, that wraps up this episode of Dudes Behind the Foods.
On this beautiful Christmas day.
Christmas time is here.
We hope y'all lay some crackers out for Jesus Christ tonight. And if you were a good boy, he will leave strawberries in your hat. So, Merry Christmas to y'all.
Christmas is real.
Thank y'all for watching. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe. Hey, man, be safe out there. I'm Tim Chantarangsu.
And I'm David Sowell.
Bye. Yo, it's the dudes behind the food.